I'm Kirk Lurie, and I'm one of the principals here at Armstrong Junior Senior High School, and I'd like to welcome you to our 2024 band concert. I would also like to introduce Mr. Mike Kalmanos, one of our other building principals here in the building tonight. We're bouncing between the two events we had. But this is one of our favorites. The talent that we have in this school from our student body is evident by what you'll hear tonight and what you've heard so far in our concerts today. We have a tremendous amount of talented students, as evidenced also by our PMEA wall we have out there in reference to all of our all-state chorus and band. But that doesn't start just with them here. It starts with you as parents and the support and grandparents that you give to these students from the time they start with their instruments. But it also is certainly a tribute to our music staff that we have here in the Armstrong School District. And not just what we have here at the high school, but what we have at Lenape Elementary and the West Hills campus. I think that our music department is absolutely one of the best out there. I always say every concert that I do an introduction that I would put our music department up against any music department in the state of Pennsylvania for what they produce. And those that are here tonight, I know Mr. Josh Meyer, our choral, the senior high chorus director, is up in the booth. Mrs. Emily Hillis, who does our junior high choruses in attendance tonight. She also does our musicals. And Mr. Rob Reams is our junior high band director. And I know he directly works with all of these students up here as well. And Mr. Jason Vineski, who I'll be introducing in just a moment, is our senior high band director. I do ask that as this concert goes on, that we shut our phones to vibrate or off, as well as our Apple Watches or anything else that makes noise. Those pitches can throw them off a little bit. I also ask that if you do have to get up and move, that you try to wait till in between numbers. And if you do have a young child who seems to get a little bit fussy, if you could get up, maybe walk to the back, step out into the lobby, and once you get that little child settled down, go ahead and bring them back in, because we certainly want them to have the ability to listen to this concert here tonight as well. Without anything, you didn't really come here to listen to me speak for 10 minutes. I can talk for 20 more if you'd like, but I certainly know that we're not here to listen to me tonight. So without further ado, I would like to introduce who I feel is one of the best music directors, and we're blessed to have him here at Armstrong High School, Mr. Jason Vineski.
Thank you. Good evening. Hope you all enjoyed the Liberty Bell March. It was originally composed by John Philip Sousa and made its encore in the Marine Band's library. If you couldn't tell, our friend CJ was playing our Liberty Bell for tonight. The song was written to envision the citizens of Philadelphia to hear the first reading of the Declaration of Independence.
On Tuesday this week, composer Drew Fennell, who composed Arlington Anthem, came to visit our school. He came and helped us listen to our piece. He wrote the song Arlington Anthem, which is written to commemorate the Arlington National Cemetery in Virginia. When he discussed how he wrote the song and what it was about, he discussed the perfectly aligned graves, which represented the soldiers who were all standing in the straight lines. All of these soldiers were then brought back to life for the song before laid peacefully to rest. This is Arlington Anthem.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody. Thank you so much. I believe the composer may be in the audience. I'm not really sure. Drew came in and worked with us today, and I think he's here tonight. So if you're here, Drew, stand up and give a wave. I know he didn't want to, but that's the point. Very nice. It's really special having, we had two composers work with us this week. Drew came in and talked about it, and Zoe did a nice job telling what he was thinking, and there were little things that he spoke to the kids about, like a light bulb went off in my head, and Ava's head, who was playing the little drum part, to how it just kind of didn't go anywhere. And he put it, it's like lives that were lost, lost too soon. And it just, wow, that just opened up a whole different world for me as a conductor and musician for that. So it was really wonderful. We have a nice treat for you today. We have, as Mr. Lorgan said, we have a lot of talented kids. This is an incredibly talented group of students, incredibly talented group of seniors, and we're going to feature some of those this evening. First, I want to feature and show you how many we have. If you are a junior county band, would you please stand up? Junior county. How about county band? County band. I don't want that to become lost in translation on the programs, okay? If you are a district band, please stand up. You're not going to see much of a change for those folks in region band. And for the Armstrong record for all states, we had three people attend all state band. Austin Stello, all state concert band. Haley Sellers, all state concert band on bass clarinet. And Zach Boyer, All-State Wind Ensemble, on Broadway. In addition, Marley Smith, in our flute section, went to All-State Choir. So Marley, please. And we had two other people from chorus make it. So we had seven go from Armstrong High School, and one from West Shamokin. So seven people total going to All-State from Armstrong School District is pretty special. So Zach and Haley are gonna play a little piece called Quintet in C Minor. English horn and bass clarinet. This is the English horn debut for this stage, I'm sure.
Thank you.
that is a culmination of a lot of time in the practice room and practicing at home. Both Haley and Zach will be going into music. Zach is going to be furthering his studies in music education at IUP, and Haley is going to be the member of the Pennsylvania Army National Guard Band, and then she plans to go on from there performing into college as well. So congratulations to both of them.
Glossius loves Skyla. Skyla does not love Glossius, as she finds his half-fish form repulsive. Glossius goes to Circe to ask her to cast a love spell on Skyla, so that she will fall in love with him. Instead, Circe falls in love with Glossius when he does not return her affections. Circe takes it out on Skyla by poisoning the water in which she was bathing. This turns Skyla into a hideous sea monster with the head of 6 serpents and a waist of 6 vicious dogs. These follows the outline of the myth, which is filled with darkness, longing, love, denial, and betrayal. visited by Dr. Weller on Monday. He told us about a student he had that struggled to fit in during school. He told us how this student decided to join his school's band where he found his people. He wrote this song based off of what he found of that student. What if the mythical stories we learned as children were only part of the truth? What if these monsters that have been hunted by man could tell us about the world from their perspective? I invite you to explore the lives of three such creatures, Quasimodo, Nessie, and Sasquatch, in this work for concert band Monsters of Myth. The suite begins with Quasimodo, Belle's first celebration. While some historical references refer to such a person, Quasimodo is believed to be the horribly disfigured creature that rings the bells of the cathedral at Notre Dame. Despite limits placed on his life, including never being permitted to leave the cathedral, it is possible he needed no other joy than daily ringing the bells of the grand cathedral for all to hear. The rollicking waltz captures Quasimodo swinging from the ropes, sounding those enormous bells to celebrate grand celebration held in the streets below.
A little bit different than normal, we'll be introducing each movement of the song. As I programmed the percussionists, instead of staying in one block, I have them all moving around the different instruments, so the next movement will also be introduced.
Didn't mean for his actions to harm humans, but rather intended to protect nature from man's intrusion and abuse. The menacing persona associated with Sasquatch is portrayed through the dissonant opening, but later transformed into a heroic theme as the creature relentlessly moves through the forest, defending animal and plant alike.
Thank you. So week concludes with Nessie, a chase around the loch. It begins on a mysterious but calm morning on the loch. Many expeditions have journeyed through, in and under the loch, in search of some sign in this famous creature. The Celtic overtones of the opening give way to a sighting. There she is, at which point a non-traditional jig begins accompanying a chase of Nessie around on the water. While various scientific outings and research have refuted the creature's existence, one could only imagine Nessie enjoying the opportunity to elude being seen and caught by mere mortals. There is a lack of hard scientific evidence to prove the existence of all three creatures, and our culture doesn't really know more than what has been recorded and speculated upon. While there are those pursuing opportunities to prove the existence of such creatures, the interim allows us for us to hold some interesting discussions as we try to see the world from their point of view.
Sleeves with that one. Each year, Murphy's Music Center, who works closely with the school district and with us, gives us the opportunity to award one of our students, typically a senior, with the Murphy's Music Center Award for Outstanding Musicianship and Excellence. The award winner tonight is a member of the All-State Concert Band. Last year, he made it to the region level, and he said, "What do I need to do to make states?" That was his overriding goal for his senior year. And we came up with some solutions, and one of which was to start studying privately. His private teacher happens to be Drew Fennell, so I have to give a lot of credit to Drew for helping him along, but he worked so hard. He was just singularly focused. So if he focuses on anything else in his life like he did, making All-State, All-State band. This kid's going to skyrocket and go far. It gives me great pleasure to award the Murphy's Music Award for Excellence to Austin Stelling. As I said, there are some incredible musicians on this stage, and not all of them have the same accolades traveling to festivals. The next two that we're going to feature tonight, Matt McClafferty and Ava Latanzio, have been featured soloists for the last several years. They're our drum captains for marching band. Mr. Reams entrusted them to play with him and another professional musician on tour. They're fabulous, and so they performed at our percussion ensemble, and then they went to the Norwin, the Western Pennsylvania Percussion Society, and performed this duet, and I thought everybody really needs to see this. So here is Matt and Ava playing Merge. Thank you. Wasn't that incredible? I want you to next time, yes. Next time you go to your keyboard, I want you to type your name with two fingers in both hands like this, and then try typing a sentence, and then try writing a book, but writing a book to a specific beat and tempo. Just absolutely amazing. Now, Matt and Ava took a semester of independent study with Mr. Reed, so they were down here every day working on that and hashing that out. They had a goal. They wanted to learn how to play four mallets and do it very well, and they certainly accomplished that. We are blessed, absolutely blessed with what we have here at this school. I'm blessed having Rob Reams work with me, feeding the band, working directly with the band, as you saw earlier. My choral colleagues, Emily Hillis and Josh Meyer, and that doesn't help, that doesn't do it all. We still need the support from administration, school board, and parents and people like you. So I'm very thankful for that. I don't take that for granted because it doesn't happen. We hear horror stories from our colleagues all over Western Pennsylvania and close to home, how bad they have it. And it's not happening here. We just keep growing, and we want to keep growing. So thank you to the administration, the school board, and my colleagues for what they do for your children. We have another treat for you. The sad things about being a band director is too often these kids get to be seniors and they are the best they've ever been making music and playing music, and then they stop. You know, life gets in the way. Fortunately, we have some students move on into higher education, into music. We have students come back. I direct the Gatanan Community Band, which meets here starting Monday night, so if anybody wants to dust off their instruments like Lori Wilson does, come on out and join us for rehearsal. But it's really special when we get to see musicians leave here, go to college, and start to blossom and bloom. 4 years ago, we were going to feature a vocal soloist in our band concert. She was a choral person all throughout school and decided to join band her senior year to get the experience. And she jumped into the percussion section and ended up playing everything. So I said, well, we should really feature you singing since you were an all-state, all-east, all-national singer and was heading to Carnegie Mellon University, shameless plug, my alma mater, to study music performance. So I'd like to invite to the stage to sing along with us Isabel Dalasek. Isabel will be graduating from Carnegie Mellon University with a bachelor's in vocal performance and a minor in drama, and then she'll continue on with her education certification. Isabel Dalasek.
Glances through my dozen. I thought it very strange and found. Pines of Rome is a four-piece movement by Italian composer Ottorino Respighi. Together, each piece forms a description of a select location in the city of Rome decorated with pine trees. Tonight, we will be performing the final movement, the Pines of the Appian Way. In the last movement, the composer recalls the past glories of the Roman Empire in a representation of dawn on the great military road leading into Rome. The final movement portrays pine trees along the Appian Way in the misty dawn as a triumphant legion advances along the road in the brilliance of the newly rising sun. Respighi wanted the ground to tremble under the footsteps of his army, which you will be able to hear from the start of the piece. Trumpets peal and the consular army rises in triumph to the Capitoline Hill. Respighi once revealed that the crescendo of Pines of the Appian Way made him feel an I don't know what in the pit of his stomach, and that it was the first time a work he had imagined turned out the way he wanted it to. We hope you enjoy Pines of Rome.
that particular solo is as written in the orchestra. So what you heard there is what the English horn player in Pittsburgh Symphony plays. Tremendously difficult. So he worked on that quite a bit. Well, we thought to end our concerts, we had kind of a big thing happen this year. We went to Florida. We spent 40 hours on a bus with teenagers. Raise your hand if you're a chaperone. Thank you very much. Round of applause for them. We went with this, chaperone and staff. It was amazing. It really was. Performing at Disney's like no other performance, tens of thousands of people. And it was even more special this time because we were the sole parade entertainment for that day. There was no other bands there all day long. We were the parade in Disney. So our hostess described it to us, kind of put it in perspective. You know, there are going to be people here from foreign countries who have never seen a marching band and may never see a marching band ever again. So, and I think the kids said, oh yeah, everybody knows a marching band. But the amount of people going through the parade route who had their phones out and were videotaping and clapping and taking photographs was just absolutely amazing. You know, we made the turn around the castle and they displayed extraordinarily well. And I'm so proud of what they did and what they accomplished. We kind of did a gear shift and changed music for Disney because that wasn't our original intent, but I'm so glad it worked out that way. So we thought since we didn't get to perform this for you locally, we'd end our concert with it. So I'm going to introduce Haley to introduce this last selection. Our drum majors will be leading Circle of Life. Thank you everybody for coming out. We still have three concerts to go here. We have a Lenape Elementary concert next week, our junior high choral concert next Wednesday, and then the Armstrong Jazz Bands the following Thursday. So it never slows down, and then we start parades in the summer. So without further ado, here's Haley.
Hello everyone. Let's give a big round of applause for Mr. Bineski. A little spoiler for the gift, we got him a Mr. Potato Head because my sophomore year, we did a parade in Kennywood and Mr. Bineski took a potato out of like a box beside the dumpster and took a bite out of it, but I didn't want to No, I didn't want to leave out Miss Bineski, so I got a Mrs. Potato Head to go with it.
And my favorite.
That was on behalf of all of the band seniors. Mr. Bineski has played a massive part in everyone's high school careers in this band. For a lot of us, music is an escape, and Mr. V guided us through it. While doing so, he also showed us how to express our creativity, everyone's silly sides, as you can tell. And he also knew when we had to get down to business. I can say me and a lot of the other people in the band have been in this building and seen Mr. Bineski more than our own parents and been here more than our home. Like musical season, I did not leave this place. I'm personally so thankful for Mr. Bineski, and I wouldn't have asked for a better high school band director. Now for our last song, Circle of Life, we're going to conclude with this song, and it's from The Lion King. I'm sure most of you know this. We played this song at Disney, as you said, straying off a little away from it. I am so incredibly proud to be able to see this band grow in numbers and in musical capabilities. Whenever I started my freshman year, I think it was like four seniors that graduated. Yeah, there was like nobody. But I'm just very sad that I have to leave this place. Now, let's get ready for the 2023 to 2024 Armstrong Riverhawks Marching Band as we play our last show.
So
have a few words to say. If any of you know me, you know I am very bad with, hey, come back, I'm not done. I'm very bad with time management and remembering things. I actually remember 2 years ago, a little bit after I was just told that I was going to be drum major, Mr. B was talking to me and he said, you're definitely a performer. We just need to work on that time management. So, as a final gift and a thank you for taking a chance on me, an on time, one of a kind, homemade gift for you to put on your wall and look at every day.